You might already know that MariaDB is a drop-in replacement for MySQL. So most of the things discussed in this video will be applicable to MySQL as well. Let's see how you can install MariaDB server on an Ubuntu 24.04 LTS version. Here I have logged into the server via SSH and you can see that it's a DigitalOcean droplet that runs Ubuntu 24.04 LTS. Start by performing an update. Apt update. Here I have logged in as the root user, so there is no need to use the sudo command. Then run apt upgrade to upgrade all the packages that can be upgraded. MariaDB server can also be installed from the apt repository. Apt search MariaDB server. And here it is. This is the one we want to install. So let me run the command apt install MariaDB server. Okay, MariaDB server is now installed. Now you can start the service. Systemctl start MariaDB. Also enable the service with systemd, systemctl enable MariaDB. Enabling a service ensures that the service also gets started when the system boots. You can check the status, run the command systemctl status MariaDB. There you can see that it's active running. Press Q to go back to the prompt. In order to strengthen the security, it's a common practice to run the MySQL secure installation script. It does a few things like removing anonymous users, test database, and strengthening the root user. To invoke the script, run the command MySQL secure installation. Alternatively, you can also run MariaDB secure installation since it's MariaDB. Both the commands are same, it's just a symbolic link. You may already know that MariaDB or MySQL has users and privileges to grant access to databases. The root user is created when you install MySQL or MariaDB. Here in the first step, it's asking for the root user's password. Since we have just installed MariaDB, the root user's password is not set. So you can just press enter to continue. The next question is about switching to Unix socket authentication. Apart from password-based authentication, socket authentication is another type of authentication in MySQL. And it's generally more secure than password-based authentication. For instance, if you set the root user to Unix socket authentication, from there on, the root user cannot be accessed with a password. Instead, you have to be logged into the operating system as the root user to access the MySQL root user. So in that way, the operating system root user is tied to the MariaDB or MySQL root user, which makes it more secure. So I think it's always a good practice to set the root user to Unix socket authentication. Then create another normal password-based user for other purposes, like accessing database. For now, I'm going to press no. Later, I will show you how to manually switch the user to socket authentication using the MySQL alter user command. Next, whether to change the root user password? No, since we will be using socket authentication. Next, MariaDB installation has an anonymous user. Remove that. Disallow remote root login? Yes. Remove test database? Yes. Reload privileges? Yes. Okay. Currently, I am logged into the operating system as the root user, so I can just run the command MySQL to log in as the MySQL root user. It opens the MariaDB prompt where I can run the command show databases to view the list of databases. Currently, there are four: information schema, MySQL performance schema, and sys. To log out from the MariaDB prompt, type exit and then press enter. You will be back to the main prompt. You can also explicitly mention the user with the dash u option, dash u root dash p. To view the list of users, you can run the MySQL command select user host plugin from mysql.user. It fetches the details from the user table of the MySQL database. Under the plugin column, you can see that the root user is set to MySQL native password. That means currently password authentication is enabled and I want to change it to Unix socket authentication. For that, I can run the alter user command. Alter user root at localhost identified via Unix socket. Query is OK. Now if I select the user details again, you can notice that the plugin value has changed for the root user. So no one will be able to access the root user using password from now on. Next, let's create a database. For that, run the command create database followed by the database name my site. Show databases. And there it is, my site. Next, let's create a new user. Create user. Username Abhinav at host localhost. Identified by password. Type in the password. List the users again. Select user host plugin from mysql.user. Here is the new user Abhinav with password authentication enabled. That means the user can be accessed with the password we have set from localhost. However, the new user has no privileges. It cannot access any database. So while we are logged in as the root user, we can grant permissions to the new user. For that, you can run the grant all privileges command. MySite dot star, that means all the tables in the database MySite, to Abhinav at localhost. Then run the flush privileges command to apply the changes. Now that the privileges are granted, I can exit from the MySQL prompt and then login again as the new user Abhinav, mysql-u-abhinav-p. I think I entered the wrong password. Let me try it again. Entering the password. Okay, I am able to login as the new user. Let's also verify the difference between a user with password authentication and a user with socket authentication. Here I was logged into the operating system as the root user. And I can successfully access the MariaDB user Abhinav that uses password authentication. But the opposite will not be possible. That means if I am logged into the operating system as user Abhinav, I cannot log into the MariaDB root user because MariaDB root user is using socket authentication. Let's verify that. Root at cnvps, run the command mysql, which logs me in as the root MariaDB user. You can run the select user function command to view the currently logged in MariaDB user. I can also log into any other MariaDB user that uses password authentication, for instance Abhinav. Run the command mysql-u username-p, then enter the password and I am logged in. Select user and you can find the currently logged in username Abhinav at localhost. Next, I am going to create a new operating system user called Abhinav. Add user Abhinav. The user is created. Let me also add that user to the sudo group in case if we want to run sudo commands. Okay. Then with the su switch user command, I can switch to the new user. On the operating system level, Abhinav at cnvps. But now I will not be able to access the MariaDB root user. If I simply run the MySQL command without any arguments, it tries to log in as the MariaDB user abhinav, but it fails because I haven't provided the password. On another side, if I try to access the MariaDB root user, mysql-u root-p, it asks for the password, but that also will not work. Even if I had set a password for the root user, it is not going to work. Why? Because the MariaDB root user has socket authentication enabled. With socket authentication, the MariaDB username and the operating system username should match. Otherwise, the authentication fails. And in order to log into the MariaDB user abhinav, I have to explicitly mention the username with the dash u option. Because with password authentication, the operating system username has no relevance, whether it's abhinav, root, or any other. Select user function, and the username is abhinav@localhost. Alright. With that being said, if it's a sudo user, then there is no problem. You can log into the MySQL root user with the command sudo mysql. Remember, I had earlier added the user abhinav to the sudo group. So running a command with the word sudo prefixed is equivalent to running the command as the root user. Next, I want to check if I can connect to the newly created database from my desktop machine as the new user abhinav. For that, I am using a database client program called DBeaver. Go to database, click new connection. Select MariaDB, next. Remember that remote connections are disabled on the MariaDB server, so we cannot directly connect to the database. So we need to set up an SSH tunnel. It allows us to securely connect to the remote server using SSH. From there, it can connect to the database as localhost. Let me go to the SSH tab, enable use SSH tunnel. Here I am going to provide with the same private key I used to SSH into the server. First, enter the server credentials, IP address, username, root. For the authentication method, select public key. Below that, enter the location of the private key file. Click test tunnel configuration to check if we can connect. Okay, it's connected. Now go to the main tab and enter the database details. Server host is localhost. Database name is mysite. Username abhinav. Here we are entering the details of the MariaDB user. Username abhinav. Password, enter the password of the MariaDB user. Click test connection. Yeah, it's connected. Finish to complete the connection. So we could successfully connect to the database via SSH tunnel. Let me open the database. Currently, there are no tables in the database. You can check the same in the server terminal as well. In the MySQL prompt, run the command use mysite, which changes the current database to mysite. Then after switching to the database, run the command show tables. Empty set, which means there are no tables. Back to the desktop client application. If I create a new table here, it should show up in the server console as well. So this is how I currently manage my databases using DBeaver. It can be seen as an alternative to phpMyAdmin. But unlike phpMyAdmin, I can manage all my database connections from a single place. Even if I have multiple servers and web applications, I can manage all the database connections using DBeaver. Also, since I am using SSH tunneling with key-based authentication, it's more secure than password-based authentication. Okay, the table is almost created. Save changes. Then going back to the server terminal, run show tables command and here is the newly created table content. Next, I want to make sure that remote connections are actually disabled on a network level. For that, I can use a tool called netstat. You can install it by running the command apt install nettools. Then run the netstat command with the -tuln option to view all the active internet connections. The one opened on port 3306 is the MariaDB connection. Here the local IP address is 127.0.0.1. It's the loopback IP address for localhost. So that ensures that MySQL can only be accessed from localhost. Remote connections from the internet are not allowed. Whereas if you look at the SSH connection on port 22, no such IP address is mentioned. So SSH connections are allowed from any IP address. We can also verify that by trying to connect to the database from DBeaver. Instead of creating an SSH tunnel, try to directly connect to the database using the server's IP address. Set the server host to the server IP address. Then enter the other details like database name, username Abhinav, and the password. Click test connection and it says connection refused, which verifies that remote connection is not allowed. Because the bind address is set to the loopback IP address 127.0.0.1, within the MariaDB configuration file located in the directory /etc/mysql. Let's perform a search in the directory find /etc/mysql, the file name -name *.cnf and execute the command -etc grep -i bind address. So the Linux find command along with the search command grep allows you to search for strings within directories. There are two results. The first one is in a file called 60galera.cnf. However, it is commented out. The second one is the one we want, 50server.cnf. There the bind address is set to the loopback IP address. So let's try opening this file in the nano editor. Here is the line that blocks remote connections. In case you want to allow remote connections, you can change the IP address to 0000. But in most cases, you should not be doing that. Okay. With that, I hope you learned how to set up a MySQL or MariaDB server on an Ubuntu server. If you found the video useful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more videos.